Hello, I'm Tim Soethout, and today I want to talk about leveraging domain knowledge to increase performance of distributed transactions. This is joint work with Thijs van der Storm and Jurgen Vinjoux. The main goal of our project is to find ways to create fast and scalable implementations from high-level domain models. In this paper and presentation, we develop a new algorithm called Path-Sensitive Atomic Commit to reduce the local coordination necessary in distributed objects without reducing local consistency, and with that, improve performance and reduce high contention bottlenecks. We all know that large software landscapes with multiple distributed applications become complicated and hard to maintain over time. In order to manage this complexity, one approach is to use high-level models using domain-specific languages to capture domain knowledge without implementation details. However, efficiently implementing these models for all possible use cases is non-trivial, since different use cases have to pick different in the inherent trade-off in distributed systems between consistency and performance. But since we have these domain models, maybe we can use these to be more efficient than general-purpose implementations can be. In particular, I focus on a domain-specific language for financial products, named REBL, which models communicating state machines. In this example, in the lower left corner, we see three synchronizing state machines. A money transfer books and coordinates with the two accounts involved, and there is an invariant that balance has to remain positive. The challenge here is to make a scalable implementation that performs well for many different similar models. A naive and well-known approach is to use blocking operations. Each state machine handles only one operation at a single moment in time, and this becomes blocking when multiple operations have to wait on other machines. Now consider this happening, for example, on a tax office bank account. This one bank account is part of a lot of transactions, for example, when collecting citizens' taxes and paying out benefits. All these deposits and withdrawals need to take place in a specific time frame to adhere to laws and regulations. If such an account was implemented using a locking implementation, all operations would have to wait on the previous to finish. All these transactions would be too slow when doing them one by one, because they also wait on the other involved account objects, which can be deployed elsewhere in a distributed application. This is what we call a high contention scenario. The bank account is the bottleneck of the system and becomes more of a problem when the number of involved transactions starts increasing. Note that for all kinds of use cases, this bottleneck could occur, especially when long-running operations, such as user input, is part of the transaction. So can we leverage specifics of these models to safely parallelize these operations in order to create a scalable implementation? Well, let's first look at the well-known locking implementation approach. Synchronization between objects is handled here by using two-phase locking for concurrency control and two-phase commit for atomicity. Two-phase locking makes sure there is no concurrent access to an object, while two-phase commit makes sure that the group of objects all make a step or none does. Together, these two guarantee serializability, meaning that the execution is equivalent to a serial execution of the application, where all operations are executed in sequence. On the right side, we see a sequence diagram of an account object implemented using two-phase locking and two-phase commit. First, a withdrawal of 30 euros arrives at the bank account. The invariant here is that balance should not go below zero. The operation is valid because enough balance is initially available. The two-phase commit transaction is started, but before the account can actually apply the operation's effects and deduct the balance, the transaction manager has to wait on other transaction participants for approval. Meanwhile, a second operation comes in, but this one has to be delayed because the account is locked. When the first operation commits, the effects can be applied, and now the second operation can start processing. When it also commits, the effects are applied as well. Note here that there's a lot of waiting going on, but also that there's actually enough balance for both withdrawals from the start. So can we use this insight? This insight, together with the notion that commit or abort of the first operation cannot influence the acceptance of the second, allows us to speed this up. For this, we devised the path-sensitive atomic commit algorithm. PSEC thus requires some information on objects and operations, such as guards and effects on the operations, and that groups of operations form atomic steps and are effectively transactions. In our domain model example, our domain-specific language example, these are defined. Now, we can look at the same example as before, but now using the domain knowledge captured in such formalism. PSEC tries to do operations in parallel, but only when it can determine at runtime that operations are independent, resulting in less waiting on other transaction participants and trading unused CPU time that would otherwise be spent waiting. This is the same example as before. On the right, we see the same withdrawal of 30 euros coming in and the two-phase commit transaction starts. But instead of the second operation having to wait, we can already start it, because we can determine that under no circumstances the outcome of the first influences the validity of the second, no matter if the first commits and applies its effects or aborts. We know for sure that enough balance is available for the second withdrawal operation. In this example, the second operation finishes early and its effects are queued. When the first also commits, the effects are applied in order of original arrival. We can see that in this way, the object can handle more operations per time unit than with strict two-phase locking, two-phase commit. The drawback, however, is that extra computation has to be done in order to determine this independent operation of independence of operations. But in most cases, the CPU is not yet fully utilized anyway and is waiting on I/O with other participants. So how do we actually determine this independence of operations? The calculation is thus done at runtime of such an object when a new master of operation arrives. Here we see how the object handles this internally. It builds up a possible outcome tree. The withdrawal of 30 euros is valid, and the possible outcome tree branches to take into account either abort on the left hand side and not doing any changes to the state, or committing on the right hand side and reducing the balance. Next, when a second withdrawal arrives, the tree branches again, because the guards of the withdrawal of 50 hold in all leaves of the previous tree, and we can already start processing it. Now, if another operation, for example, withdraw 60 euros comes in, we see that only in some cases its guards hold. Therefore, we have to delay its execution until we know more. When the withdrawal of 50 commits, we can now prune the outcome tree, and we can clearly see that the withdrawal of 60 is never valid, and you can signal the failure directly. When the first operation now commits, we prune the tree again, and we are in a single state again, and we can apply the committed operations in order of original arrival. In order to evaluate this algorithm and show its effect in high contention scenarios, we implemented this idea on top of actors using the AKA toolkit on the JVM. Each object is run as an actor and communicates via messages. The state of the object is persisted in an event log in a database, in this case Cassandra. These experiments were also run in an automated and reproducible fashion on Amazon Web Services, and we also published our data and results on Zenodo. We compare two-phase locking, two-phase commit against PSEC, where two-phase commit and two-phase locking is a special case of PSEC, where we limit the number of parallel operations for an object to one. This also means they share most of their implementation and convinces us that we are really comparing the algorithm's difference. We consider three scenarios, which covers extremes in the contention landscape. A no-sync scenario corresponding to operations without synchronization, where the load generator tries to do as many requests as possible on different objects. So in this case, there is no synchronization between objects, and we would expect around the same performance for both algorithms, since there is no extra parallelism possible. A sync experiment where we book a money transfer object, which synchronizes with two account objects picked uniformly from 100,000 accounts. Here we might expect PSEC improving over two-phase locking, two-phase commit, since some transfer overlap on accounts is possible, and PSEC can actually handle them in parallel. And last is the sync 1000 experiment, which is the same as the sync, but picked from only 1000 accounts to simulate a really high contention scenario. Here we see plots that show the maximum sustainable throughput with increasing node counts. For the first two experiments, they perform similarly. Apparently, there's not enough contention yet. But Pesach at least performs at least as good as two-phase locking, two-phase commit. Since the Sync 1000 is the most interesting case, we also ran it for higher node counts. Here we see that Pesach consistently achieves higher throughput, two-phase locking, two-phase commit. We also saw, but not shown here, that its latency is always similar or lower than two-phase locking, two-phase commit. So that's really nice. Pesach performs at least as good as two-phase locking, two-phase commit in all of our cases, which represent different extremes, and gives us confidence that it could be a good replacement. So to conclude, what did we see today? We saw a performance bottleneck when a lot of requests are handled by single objects in the form of a text account example. These kinds of use cases become a bottleneck when handling everything sequentially and locking in between, especially in high contention scenarios. Using domain knowledge, we can determine at runtime for which operations it is safe to actually execute them in parallel, using more computation when the objects are waiting for other transactions. We investigated this with path-sensitive atomic commit, which is the title of our talk. Currently, we are investigating the exact isolation guarantees that Pesach gives over multiple transactions and objects. We also evaluated if Pesach indeed improves performance in a high contention scenario and found that this is the case by running it on increasing node counts. We saw that it performs at least up to par to two-phase locking and two-phase commit and better in high contention scenarios. All in all, we feel that this approach can really help in creating performant implementations using domain knowledge from models where general purpose implementations cannot. Thank you for attending my talk, and I hope I triggered interest in our work.